You require information.
Yes, thank you. Yes, I read a book about you by Adrian Dwyer.
I am understanding there has been material written.
Yep, it was called X-ray Extraterrestrial Medicine.
That would be an appropriate title.
Uh-huh.
What did it say?
So Adrian Dwyer was introduced to already existing network of healers who collaborated with the aliens in Israel. And it was in the 90s and it was in the 90s, like about 10 or 12 years. And he had a wonderful scientific mind, so he asked wonderful questions, and you answered them, and he described what your conversations.
Very well. What is it that you need to know then?
What happened after that? So I think he died around 2004, more or less. So it's 14 years later. I mean, the book was, I think, around 2001. So what happened in the last 18 years?
There is much that has happened. There is an expansion of this work in Israel, but it also has expanded to Russia and some places in the United States. Also, there is one small area in the north part of the United Kingdom where there is a small underground lab. There's a lot of alien connection there, and so that is why they choose that area. Very easy to connect with aliens on a third dimensional level there. But
which organization is doing this on the alien side?
We are Yahyel.
What's the relationship of you with Girk Fitneer?
Girk Fitneer has a Yahyel population. That is not who we are, but there are many Yahyel in the universe in different places. I am not from that particular alliance, but I do work with humans because I believe it's necessary for them to have this understanding. I believe the reason for my work is that they need to survive, but this kind of energy would have been discovered very shortly anyway, and had been already discovered, but not understood. And they could have destroyed themselves with not understanding this energy properly. They could have destroyed themselves if they added certain technologies to it incorrectly.
Is it the same energy which is described by Constantine Mail? He calls it scalar waves?
Yes, that is part of it. Yes, it is similar. I have to say, yes.
And also there is a device which is developed by Dan Winter, which uses also similar waves, which is a combination of Royal Reich's device, but modified to produce spiral waves, or better say helical waves with which collapse at a certain angle.
Yes.
So is it the same energy as you describe? It's basically Dan Winter's machine.
Yes. It has to be. It's used more effectively with technology and machinery rather than in its raw form. As it's being used, it can manipulate the energy structures within the framework of the body in very positive or very negative ways, depending on how it's used.
So are you open to accept more healers? What's your criteria? Who can work with you?
Those that are accepted into the program usually have strong energetic abilities and are resilient to energetic forces. They have to be rather healthy and rather upstanding. They have to be loyal to the program. There are a few ways that we choose our participants, and that is that they are very carefully chosen. And it is a secret society in the sense that they cannot speak about it.
So why did Adrian Dwyer die? I mean, he died earlier.
It was his time to go. I could not prevent that.
I see. Tell me more about DNA. So how is the X-ray energy interacting with the DNA code, with the genomic code?
It interacts with, it depends on the way that it is sent into the body, into the DNA. You understand DNA is in the entire body, of course. So it is the way that it is sent into the body, how the DNA reacts to it. It can react in a stimulus way, as has been mentioned before. It speeds up the activation of the DNA, or it can actually slow down the reaction of the DNA, which causes the body to last longer and live to greater years. But it has to be the exact vibrational equivalence of the body and the right language to the DNA. There are so many languages the DNA has. It has a chemical or more than one chemical language, but when it comes to its energetic languages, it has many kinds of energetic languages and sequences. Now, to start a sequence, you need the right stimulus with the right energy. Chemicals can be involved with that as well. So there is the entrance of the right chemical and energetic sequences to enhance muscle tone, brain, thought waves, the organs of the body, etc. So therefore, many experiments were done on animals and humans, and some were very successful and some were not. But we have seen that every human has a precise vibrational code within them that separates them from every other human, and their DNA is separated from every other human because of this vibrational difference. And so to find that is the first thing, and to speak to it properly is the next thing. It took many years for us to decipher some of the energetic and chemical codes and their sequences to the brain and body. It is that there is more than one energetic code that can cause similar things. This makes the DNA very complicated, and you must know the intention of the sequence exactly to bring about the proper outcome. Because it may appear that the sequence is doing one thing, but it is actually preparing for another sequence that builds on top of it.
Okay, I got it. So one of the most interesting things that I found in Adrian's book was that the memory, at least I think short-term memory, is kept in, is synthesized in synapses in the form of microtubule strings. So yeah. Synapses are the places where one neuron touches another. So it's a connection points between the neurons.
Right.
So microtubules are actually inside and outside of the neurons, and they constantly are built and degraded. So they kind of strings that grow and shrink all the time. So Adrian Dvir said that the growing of the molecules, he didn't say microtubules, but the growing of the molecular polymers in the neurons is responsible for short-term memory. Can you clarify that?
Yes, it is true. Now, what has been learned about that also is that they act much like blood vessels in some ways, contracting and expanding in response to DNA activity and brain activity. Do you understand that?
I barely.
Very well. But these responses... Well,
let me ask another thing. Okay, go ahead.
Well, I just wanted to say it is important that they expand and contract, because it shows where the sequence is ending and beginning. That is one of the results of a DNA sequence is synapse.
So basically, synapses are located very far from DNA. The neurons are very long, like our neurons, yeah, in the spine. They have the nucleus with DNA is located in the spine, but the endings of the neuron located in the skin. So some of them are like about 1 meter long. The place where the endings of the neuron contact another neurons are called synapses, and they are like very, very far from the DNA. So I just wonder how could the signal or the information can be transferred from the synapse, which is outside of the nucleus, very far, yes, to the nucleus where the DNA is.
Yes, you have to understand that even though the DNA is not close to the synapse, that is true, that they are sending energetic and chemical responses to the entire body for the purpose of reaction and results. They must have a certain result, and sometimes that result is a synapse that must occur so that the proper action is taken in the body or in the nervous system. So you must understand that even though they are not seemingly connected, they have to be for the body to properly respond and be properly interactive.
So I know several ways how the information can be transferred. One way is obviously through action potential. Basically, it's electric charges traveling through the neuron.
Yes.
And it's a sort of very slow and very, very suspicious way of communication. It doesn't seem to be too informative. Another way would be through microtubules.
The slower responses are directly from the DNA. The DNA is a slow responding thing. It has fast and slow responses. The slower responses are the basis for other responses and reactions. This is to build a base for another response, to build a base to react in proper ways to all things in the system.
So another way to connect, another way to transfer information is through microtubules. Apparently, microtubules go through the neuron inside, and also there is a network of microtubules outside of neuron that can transfer information through the tubules.
Energy and chemical. The DNA works with energies and chemicals. And yes, that is absolutely true.
And the third way, I think, would be some tunneling, essentially, transfer of information without obvious carriers, just through resonances between distant pieces of the body.
Yes. But what causes all these things? What is the basic... where is the beginning to these responses, or the beginning to these things? It all comes from chemical and electrical. They are all stimuli. The DNA is the basis of all the releasing of all the information to the brain so it can react properly. It is the circuitry that the DNA uses to get the work done.
Yeah, one of the questions which we had was, where is the memory stored? Is it stored in the physical, or is it stored in the other dimensional place and only retrieved when it's needed?
Both. It can be stored in physical and fourth dimensional or whatever other dimensional. Let me give you an example of that. Sometimes when an arm is amputated, people will still feel the energy in that arm, or feel be able to feel that arm still, even if it's not there, because the DNA sends out the basic blueprint of the body. And in the basic blueprint, there is still that arm. In the basic blueprint and the energy of the arm, it still sends energy to that area.
So that comes close to the idea of Sheldrake about the morphogenic field. So in classical in biology, we believe that the shape of the body is stored in the genome, and Sheldrake suggested that genome is not stored in the shape of the body, it's only the key and antenna, the device, the reading device, but it reads the shape from the morphogenic field outside of the physical.
Yes.
And that as we evolve, as the evolution happens, the shape of human body and the structure of human body is evolving in the morphogenic field, and humans only read it from there.
Exactly. That is true.
Oh, wow. So that makes it a little more difficult to study from the physical. It's, much of that is inaccessible to us.
That is true. But you see where I'm saying that this is fact. That it is a fact that if someone loses a body part, energy still goes to where that body part should be. And that energy is from the DNA and from the blueprint, or from the thought process that should still be there, but may not be, but it still will feed that with energy. Do you get that?
My last question is personal. I'm been sick for the last 3 weeks. And it's very unusual sickness. It's more like energy sucked out of me, and I don't see any infection or any other usual symptoms. Can you fix it?
If I had my work with me, I could fix it. I cannot fix it right now, but I can come to you later, help you to rebalance the system and bring all things into alignment in a proper way so that you feel better.
Wonderful. That would be great. Do I need to prepare in any way?
No. You cannot prepare. There's no way for you to prepare.
I would welcome your therapy.
Except for, I could say that if you are hydrated, that would work better.
Uh-huh. I also have problem with my hydration. Somehow the water just doesn't absorb well. There is some weird relationship with water these days.
Understood. But hydration is important. So if everything works better electromagnetically and chemically with hydration.
I had one more question which I wanted to ask also. So there are basically lots of electromagnetic pollution here. This would be Wi-Fi, microwaves from the microwave oven, and the telephone, cell phone waves. Do you think that these are very negative, and which ones would be worse out of three?
Well, they're all bad. But let me tell you this. As they are continuing to become more prevalent, the body will evolve to include them in its network in some way. So because it realizes that it must either be destroyed or develop a way to deal with these particular rays. And so they will, the first humans that are in contact with them will probably not evolve, but as time moves forward, man will evolve to accept these waves in a more natural way so that they can survive with them.
Oh, thank you. This is all I have. I have to bring Jim back because of the timing. Thank you very much for your conversation, information, and help.
You're welcome.
And don't forget to visit me. I need your help.
I will visit you later.
Thank you.